Hello and welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Konrad Sippel, who is the head of research at Solactive AG. Great to have you on the line, Konrad. And just for anybody not familiar with Solactive, could you get us up to speed with what the company actually does?
Absolutely. Great to be here. Solactive is an index provider out of Frankfurt, Germany. We provide a lot of indices to over 25,000 different products that underlie ETFs and structured products. And one of our big strong points is thematic investing. And we're here today, and you can kind of see it in my background as well, to talk about electric vehicle charging infrastructure, which is one of the sort of investment themes that we like a lot here at Solactive.
Thank you very much, Konrad. So yes, electric vehicle charging, and one of the big events in the calendar relevant for certainly for you, Konrad, was COP27. So was there anything that came out of COP27 that was relevant to EV charging?
Yeah, so we looked at COP27 with a lot of hope. I mean, you know, obviously COP27 is a follow-on from COP21, the Paris Agreement, and the road to net zero. And transportation makes up about 20% of those carbon emissions that we're looking to reduce. And obviously, the electric vehicle is one of the answers to that. So yes, we did look at COP27, but I think like most observers, we've been fairly disappointed in the sense that COP27 hasn't really accelerated everybody's commitment towards net zero. But I guess it also hasn't made things worse. So in a sense, with regards to kind of how we're going to go about getting to net zero, it's let's keep going with what we've been doing beforehand. And, you know, I'm happy to translate that into a bit of good news and to say that, you know, the commitment towards a carbon-free mobility is still there. And we're also seeing that with sort of some of the actions that the governments are taking.
Mm-hmm. Now, last time you were on, you spoke to one of my colleagues and said that you believe that the private sector is really going to have to foot the bill for the transition towards electric vehicles. Do you believe that's still the case?
So I think yes. So the private sector is going to have to do it. So that it's going to be left to the private sector to put up those chargers and those stations. With regards to footing the bill, there's a few commitments that maybe help here. So Germany's committed to a 6.6 billion euro package over the next 3 years. They're looking to expand the number of charging stations in Germany to 1 million charging stations. To put that into context, that's about 70 times as many charging stations as we have today. And it's going to be like a major push towards, you know, making adoption of the electric vehicle a little easier for the consumers. Because you've got to remember that by 2035, we're going to stop selling gasoline-based cars, and everybody's going to kind of be forced into going electric. And the lack of charging infrastructure remains one of the key points that stops people from buying electric vehicles.
Mm-hmm. Something else that may be a concern to anybody potentially thinking of picking up an electric vehicle is that electricity at the moment is actually unusually expensive. So is it something that you're keeping a close eye on, the price of electricity?
So we're having a look at that. And I think if you'd asked me that same question a month ago, I would have said, yep, I'll have to admit that there are some reports out that it's currently more expensive to charge an electric vehicle than to refuel a gasoline-based car. But that's actually changed already a bit. So one of the companies in our index, Fastned, they've just made a big announcement that they're reducing the price for the kilowatt hour for charging again. And I think, you know, all the projections that we've seen kind of go towards saying that, you know, it's in the long run, it's going to be substantially cheaper to charge an electric vehicle than a gasoline-based one.
Mm-hmm. One thing I'd be particularly interested to get your take on, Konrad, is whether you think that there's anything that you think the public don't really truly understand about this EV revolution. Do you think that there are things that people need to be more aware of?
So I think generally speaking, the belief in that we will really have a majority of vehicles electric just isn't there because people are not seeing it. You know, so the overall percentage of EVs, and that includes plug-in hybrids, is something like 4%. So you know, four out of 100 cars that you're going to see on the road is going to have some form of electric engine. So to everyone, that sort of still feels like EVs is something, you know, it's a toy for the rich. You know, the Teslas are on everybody's mind. And I think what hasn't sunk in with anybody yet quite is that there are sales bans that are going to kick in 2035. And by 2040, 60% of us are going to own an electric vehicle, whether we have access to charging at home or not. And I think, you know, that's something that we're trying to expand. And if you look at new vehicle registration rates, they tend to be, depending on which country you look at, but they tend to be between 30 and 50%. So clearly the percentage of EVs is rising. But I think what most people aren't seeing is that this is going to be an exponential rise that's going to see us go from 4% to 60% over the next 25 years or so.
Wow. One final question from me, Konrad, is that one particular version of the future that people have envisaged is that in the end, people won't so much be owning private cars as that there'll be a fleet of automatic electric vehicles somewhere out in the countryside. And when you need to get somewhere, rather like if you were going to use an Uber nowadays, you would simply summon the vehicle using your phone and then it would come and take you where you needed to go and then go off and you wouldn't actually own the vehicle at all. Is that a version of the future that you recognize?
I think I'd love that. Being a city child, I guess owning a vehicle isn't necessarily something that you have to have. So this idea is great, but I think for the charging infrastructure, those vehicles will still have to go and charge somewhere. Hopefully, fully automatic and electric, and then maybe, you know, the question of real estate and location for the charging station becomes less important if the vehicle just sort of goes off into some outskirts and charges itself. But, you know, I think in the bigger cities, in the more concentrated population areas, I do see that as a realistic alternative. I'm, you know, also seeing a lot more like electric buses and, you know, like public transportation moving more electric, but it doesn't remove the need for charging those vehicles.
Understood. Well, Konrad, thank you very much for joining me this morning on Proactive. It was a pleasure.
Yeah, thank you very much.